So understand, the reason why I am sitting in one place, I am establishing whatever is required. You see, for example, this Sacred Arts University. Because I sat in one place and made the whole structure happen, now I can supply for all our ashrams the traditional pillars. We can build any number of temples, deities, everything. The mechanism is set now. Even if we have to build 100 temples per year, we can support. The mechanism is in place. If you have visited Bidhi Ashram, you will know we have 2,500 stone pillars accumulated, 1,500 teakwood pillars accumulated. It's not a small joke. Even if you have money, you won't be able to get it. This all lot of work, where old houses are being sold, we go and buy the whole house and dismantle it and take and sell the land back. It's a lot of work which I have to be sitting and personally managing the whole thing of this accumulation, the process. It's like I can say that tons of things are being done, organizing, unsaid, which can't be said or which is not known to you guys. If you visit the Sacred Arts or University, only then you will understand. You will not take these deities for granted. You will understand how much it takes for them to stand here on the stage, whether the making the deity or their jewelry or the cloth. If they are standing here, at least 6 months work of 25 people. This all hand carved, don't think machine made. How many of you have seen our Sacred Arts University? Then you can understand what I am saying. And almost 10 lakh palm leaves we have collected, and more than 1 lakh published old Indo-traditional books we have collected, manuscripts, and we have organized all that. It's getting uploaded freely in the internet. All this work I will not be able to do if I am traveling. This all side by side happened. I think I have forgotten a lot. If some of the Mahans, if you remember anything which I have forgotten, you can remind me. Akashic readings, Kalbhairava Darshan, and Nirahara Samyama, Balavidyalaya program, pregnancy care program, Goshala, Nitya Yoga, detox programs, centers worldwide. Nirahar Samima, I said it. Bhagashastra, Kumbh, that is a program. Kumbh Mela is a program. I am saying so much has happened just because I sat in one place. We can't even list out. If I was traveling, I will not be able to do all this organizing, may not have happened. You see, it's like a bringing legitimacy work is totally different from preaching. First 7 years I was sharing my enlightenment, preaching, teaching, giving experience to people, all that. This next 7 years I am bringing legitimacy to the whole Hindu tradition. Collecting, analyzing, organizing.
I guess we are just greedy to have you closer to us, Swamiji. That's why.
I'll come. I know. Even I also want to come. I just wanted to come and see Los Angeles Venkateshwara and all the temples, especially this Ohio Anandeshwara, Los Angeles Venkateshwara, San Jose Meenakshi, and Houston Dakshinamurti, and all is personally carved by me. All those deities I carved personally. And for the Seattle Nataraja, 5 days I slept in the workshop in Kumbakonam. 5 day and night. In those days we did not have my own cook. So nearby mess means the old ladies cook and serve. So in that mess, one idli 50 paise. And other than idli, that old lady doesn't know what to make anything. So morning 5 idli, noon 5 idli, evening 5 idli. And with that idli, 5 days I slept and made the Seattle Nadraja in Kumbakonam. Because those days we did not have our own workshop. Now only we have our own workshop. So that time the work was different. Now it is time, the work is different. I also wanted to come and see all of them. Because all of that, see, there was a time where I have to pour my blood to make a temple happen. Then there was a time if I just put my sweat, the ashram's temples used to happen. Now if I just look, it happens. And it is that this simplifying has been done because I sat in one place. Sat in one place and brought legitimacy to the whole Hindu tradition. Because I sat in one place only, I was also able to write so many books and give commentary on so many things, organize so many things. When I look back, I feel, oh God, what we have done. I do want to come, maybe next year. We'll have inner awakening, one inner awakening maybe.
That would be really nice, Swamiji. And we need your blessings to grow the, I think Pascal and Aya and Tejaswami has done a wonderful job at the Toronto Sangha, but there's a lot of South Asians in Toronto who are
I think if I come, I may come to the Canada only first. I may come to Toronto only first.
Thank you. But Swamiji, one of the concerns I have is there's a lot of Hindus, but a lot of us have lost our roots. I mean, I grew up in Toronto for nearly 28, 30 years. And yes, I'm a Hindu and I do go to the temples, but we don't know a lot of details that we need to know.
That is my job now.
Thank
Educating
you.
All of you, getting Hindus back to live Hinduism. That's my responsibility. I'll do it. I'll create enough literature and presentation, understandings and knowledge, sources, satsangs, so you guys can start living it. My blessings.
That would be great. And one of the things that when I was here, I was seeking is, what's the purpose of my life? I always wanted to be the best businesswoman as much as possible. As part of that, I want to also do service.
You see, pick up the enlightenment as the goal. In that goal, you will express intensity to make your business successful and to make your service, all the other goals will be fulfilled by the energy expressed by your seeking itself. I want to tell this to all of you. Keep enlightenment as the goal of your life. With that goal, the pressure and intensity which gets built, that energy which gets built, will make you realize all the other goals. All the other goals will become reality. All the other goals will become reality just with that one goal. Keep that alive, living goal. Keep that alive and the first goal as a first priority. The intensity and the energy, authenticity, that goal awakens in you is enough to fulfill all other goals. Because that goal will literally awaken your very God particle. your very God particle will be kept alive. That will take care all the other things, your business, your family, service, these, that, everything will be proper.
Last question, Swamiji.
Yes, go ahead.
In the beginning, I was able to read to third eye a couple of words, but in the last few days,
With this mother incompletion being pulled out, that's the only thing. Today it will be clear.
So
today we are moving to the next. You will be able to read.
I need your blessings to read sentence, Swamiji.
Tathast.
Thank you.
I'll make you read books. Don't worry.
Thank you very much. Thank you. And we are really thoroughly enjoying the program, Swamiji. Thank you very much.
Blessings.
Left Swamiji, side, Swamiji. Wild side.
Go ahead.
Pranam, Swamiji. I wanted to share a couple of experiences. About 6 years ago, I had knee surgery, and it never really fully healed. Sometime last week, during one of the processes, I experienced intense pain. Usually, the pain is very mild to barely noticeable. So during the process, it was really intense. After you gave us the Atmalinga, the first process that you did, I didn't feel any pain at all. It's come back since, but not too much.
It'll be healed immediately.
Okay, Swamiji.
I'll heal.
One other request I have, Swamiji. Will we have Devi Darshan?
What else you are having? Come on.
Swamiji, Trishul Sai. Trishul Sai.
Swamiji, just need a blessing, Swamiji. Though it is a very wild dream coming true to be in the Advaita with you, but still subtly I have a lot of fear also to be in Advaita with
you. I'll clear it.
Thank you, Swamiji.
Swamiji, Trishul Sai.
Go ahead.
Many people have, I think, are wondering what exactly is the Sarvanyapitam project. Maybe it may be helpful to talk a little
bit about it. Sarvanyapitam project is just reviving whole Hinduism, bringing legitimacy to, spiritual legitimacy to Hinduism. I am reviving, see, in Agama is the direct teachings of Mahadeva. In the Agama, Mahadeva gives 400 spiritual powers, the whole science, just like third eye. 400 powers he gives us as science. And like a traditional battery, traditional aircraft and submarines, all that circuits and science he explains. Apart from these 400 powers, this whole thing, I am trying to demonstrate it scientifically, logically, rationally, in a foolproof way, demonstrating and making it reproducible. So I am building a spiritual scientific laboratory to make this whole thing happen. That is Sarvangapita, where you will be physically shown all these 400 powers by various people, which can be under the controlled conditions, which can be demonstrated logically, foolproof, scientifically, and it can be reproduced on the people whoever goes through that process. And this kind of this traditional circuits, submarines, the traditional flights, all these, some of the circuits we are already successful in establishing the circuits, but making it into a usable, practical, I am working and doing further research on that, trying to make all that available to people. Making it available. So naturally all these will bring a spiritual legitimacy to Hindu tradition. So I want the world to know our masters had a great knowledge in the inner world and the outer world, and they are not fools. They existed in a very high level of intelligence and energy, and it is possible to have the benefits of all that even now. So, bringing spiritual legitimacy to the Vedic tradition and making the whole thing user-friendly, where you can directly use it. If I make the battery as per the Vedic tradition, eco-friendly, and make it available for all you guys to use it every day, only then I feel I am successful in convincing you on the wisdom of our ancient rishis. If I make the third eye as everyday lifestyle for you, only then I feel I made Mahadeva relevant to you. I am not interested in making Mahadeva just as a faith in you. I am making Mahadeva as a relevant experience to you. Whether it is third eye or all the other things he describes in Agama, inch by inch, step by step, I am making it as a direct experience relevant to your life. Relevant to your everyday life. I can say within next 2 years I'll be successful spiritually establishing the legitimacy of all these 400 powers and all these major circuits. My plan was by 40, I'll be turning 40 in 2017. Now I'm completing 38 in coming January 3rd. I'm completing the 38 and entering into 39. So next January 2017, I'll be entering into 40. 2018 January, I'll be completing the 40. So by 2017 end means we have 2 more years. In 2 more years, I'm very confident and clear I'll establish the spiritual legitimacy of these 400 powers. And these basic circuits. Then it can be shared with the whole world and world can understand the great legacy, spiritual legacy of the Vedic tradition, the Hinduism. And the people who are not interested in this, people who are afraid that this should not happen, they attacked me. But utterly and bitterly they failed. They utterly failed and bitterly failed. In this whole attack, in this whole war, who are the losers, you know? The onlookers, the so-called old devotees who believed their attack, they are the losers. The fellows who attacked me, they understood nothing can be done to Nityananda. Let's go somewhere else. And they have gone to some other people. It's like for them it's a life. If not Nityananda, somebody else. They will be doing their job. And for me, I can never lose. I am always a winner. I have to establish, because the great energy and the experience, the realization with which, the mission with which I am landed, I have to make it happen. And neither I am a loser, nor, even though they lost this battle, they will go with another, they are engaged. The real loser in this whole game is the fellows who were onlookers, the so-called devotees who believed the attack, they are the real losers. I'll make sure these fellows will not have any guru for next janmas. Janmas they should not have any guru. They will not. The losers are those fellows. Nobody else. Nobody else is the loser in this whole game. This whole fun. Actually, it's all fun. There were a lot of people without having the authenticity, just getting the benefits very easily and taking it for granted. And it's good. Now we are rid of all those fellows.